Excited. We changed the music from reggaeton, hip-hop to Mexican corrido. You know what I'm saying? We start prepping ourselves to get into that Mexican culture. It's a great feeling, man. And then once you cross the border, you know, me, you know, for somebody new, it'll kind of be confusing, but for me, since I've crossed so many times, I've peeped how you move, how you talk to people. Money is very important.
On the way to Mexico, you see, we got to take all this stuff right here with my grandpa.
Is he going?
Ya está listo para ir?
Competencia.
Yeah. Ready. We're about an hour away from the border.
What's up, my fella? You ready? You ready?
Yeah.
You ready?
Yeah.
You excited?
Yeah, we're hot right now.
Hey,
yeah.
It's like this water.
Yeah, we're an hour away.
Take a lot, just take enough to get you through a couple situations. You gotta move, you know. People expect from Border Patrol, man, we're all human, you know. There's some people that be afraid, you know, they. But I mean, if you ain't got nothing to hide, why you afraid for? So we're going to visit family. We're gonna go have a good time. And of course, you got some cops there, you know. You got some good ones, you got some bad ones. Some just want some money, just give them some money, you know. They just want to take home some money for their family. So I just give them a little Christmas gift, you know, and keep it moving. But at the end of the day, we all human. We should be able to understand. And if you're going over there with good intentions, then you shouldn't be worried about a thing.
Watch, they gonna stop my ass right now, watch. They always stop me right here, always. Put my window down a little. Yeah, so you just don't put it all the way down.
People understand you with money, you know, so yeah, that's how you move in Mexico. Of course, the food is different. If you don't eat spicy, sorry for you. You know what I'm saying? But other than that, You could tell the difference in everything.
Where they have gone. What get it?
Parabrisas, micas y es.
Mexico, Piedras Negras, in the border. Y'all about to see how I go down over here, real Mexico. Not no tourist area. We in the mainland. We.
So the compound is called Quinta del Sol. It's owned and operated. Well, it's owned by my uncles, my mom's two older brothers, Jose Guadalupe Rodriguez and Jose Isabel Rodriguez. They're both Jose's.
We have the bar area. So, Quinta del Sol. The sun, Quinta.
right? Yeah, so it's nice. This is like a ballroom over here where they make the dinner, set up tables for people to eat.
Set up tables for people to eat and stuff.
I could have worked.
It's like the ballroom there. It's nice. This is where they set tables up and they do all the cooking there.
Yeah.
Got all this. It's nice, right?
My grandfather's name is also Jose, so all of them were named Jose, just with a different middle name. But as far as the compound, man, it used to be a bloquera where they used to make blocks. That's how they started it. They fenced it around and they started it as a business. Didn't work out. The place was alone for a couple years. My uncles were drinking sometime. Like, let's just say, out of nowhere they were drinking, they came up with a crazy idea. Let's say, let's make it happen. It started off with one building, then another building, then a bar, then this. And it's been made to what it is now. And they still have future plans to expand it. This is a beautiful place for the family goes there. Something that, a legacy that the uncles build, because, coming from a background where they came from, none of that was, you can't even dream of stuff like that, you can't even dream of stuff like that. And now for them to have it, it's a big accomplishment for them and for the family as well.
Right here, it's the family church. We come here, people get married here, people baptize, for the holidays, everybody come here. You know what I'm saying? Gotta give thanks to God, always. It's nice, right?
The problem? Yeah, that shit was nice. I never seen that shit ever.
For real?
It's the first time I come here.
Look,
check
over here. I got my homie. We shooting, bro.
He came from Atlanta too.
This is my little Jeep, bro. We got it over here. I'ma fix it up. I bought a classic. I'ma fix it up. I'ma raise it. Of course, I gotta remodel everything. That one's mine. This is my uncle's. He brought it from Atlanta. He got the razor. I'll show you outside this one. This is little Cabanas. Yo, Kike. Hey, wait! No time for that. This is my uncle, my mom's brother. You met my grandpa, that's his dad. And that's Kike, my cousin. So these little cabanas, you know what I'm saying? Little but nice. We got the bedroom upstairs with just a bed, a bathroom, closet. What's up? Say what's up, Kike.
What's good, man?
Look at him, living the light. Look like a king, dog. Yes, come on, bro. Right here, we got the pool, man, in the springtime, in the summertime, private parties. You can have some guys singing over there, just having a good time. You gonna see everything, bro. It's nice.
See that it's possible, you know what I'm saying? It's just a lot of hard work, dedication.
Right?
Right.
Anything is possible, bro. If they could do it, imagine. And they ain't know how to speak English. They ain't know nothing. You know what I'm saying? Third, fourth grade education. You got all this. Doing it the right way.